Back in the late 1800s, the railroad was the lifeblood of the West, bridging the unsettled plains of western Kansas and the thriving towns of eastern Kansas along the Missouri River. Atchison was a railroad town, and it was in the summer of 1882 that one of Atchison's great railroad legends was born. One early morning in August, the mail train was rounding a curve between Cawker City and Glen Elder, approaching the bridge over Granite Creek. The engineer was a man named Britt Kraft, who was regarded as the crack engineer of the line.
But just around the bend lay a challenge not even Britt Kraft could meet. A bridge was on fire, and Kraft couldn't see it. Instantly, he was faced with two choices: to save himself or his passengers. He could try to go as fast as he could and get the engine across the burning bridge, or he could slam on his brakes, and the engine would tumble into the creek below.
To Kraft, his passengers came first. He slammed on the brakes, the engine left the track, and tumbled to the creek bed below. The stunned passengers walked away unhurt. Their cars had stopped short of the burning bridge. Kraft was thrown from the engine and killed. He wound up here. Kraft was remembered for his distinguished service and heroism. His headstone in Mount Vernon Cemetery is 7 feet tall and bears the likeness of a steam engine, just like the one Kraft operated. The bridge was rebuilt, but the spirit of Britt Kraft remained. Days later, the Atchison Globe carried the remarkable story of Kraft's reappearance. As the first train approached the new bridge, the engineer said he distinctly heard an engine whistle ahead of him. He leaned out the window to look ahead and saw a phantom engine outlined in white coming around the curve. And leaning out the cab window was none other than Britt Kraft. After the train crossed the bridge, the engineer, pale and stricken, looked at his fireman and said, "I have seen the ghost of Britt Kraft's engine."